Hello and welcome to part two of PaintShop Pro Basics, episode 39, the Background Eraser Tool. Now, I left off mentioning that you can unmix colors that have been mixed together around soft edges using a specific value in PaintShop Pro. I'm pretty sure that most, by the time they saw that, were going, oh, we have to change the hardness setting, right? Because the hardness is how hard or soft the brush is. No. Hardness refers to how hard or soft the geometry of the brush is. And PaintShop Pro relies very, very heavily on the geometry of the brush to erase the background with. So the last thing you want to be doing is limiting how much geometry there is in the brush. Now, PaintShop Pro, in order to deal with soft edges, gave us a completely different option called sharpness right over here. Traditionally, this is set to about 70, so I'll just go ahead and do that. Sharpness determines how sharp or soft an edge is between the foreground and background colors. And I've zoomed in here on the image so we can see this. Oops. Yeah, okay. You can see the sign here is very straight-edged. It has a very sharp, defined edge to it. The trees on this side, however, are very blurry. They have a very soft edge. So I'm going to show you the big difference between using a hard edge sharpness and a soft-edged sharpness. When using a large sharpness, we want the edges to be very, very sharp. So I can erase around the sign. No problems. It will just define the sign for me and we'll go straight on through. No problems. But you'll notice that as we get into the trees, we still get that little halo effect. Or we erase the leaves entirely. If we bring the sharpness down, that halo effect is pretty much gone. As we go over everything, as it unmixes the color, it's actually subtracting blue from the result and giving us only the soft edged leaves. And I'm going pretty well over the sign, but if I get too close, look what happens. It starts to erase the color from the sign and we get this ridiculous semi-transparent edge. So in order to deal with this, we have to use a higher sharpness on the sign and then switch to a lower sharpness as we get into the trees. And we'll be adjusting the size of our brush and the sharpness throughout our image as we slowly go along. Now there's another problem that you probably noticed is that as I'm trying to get down in here, the little holes that of sky are not being erased. In fact, I had to get so close to the tree that I sampled the tree and now the tree is being erased. And it still didn't erase those portions of the sky. What's going on? Well, what's going on is an option called limits. Right over here. By default, limits is set to contiguous. What contiguous means, and I'll show you by increasing the size of my brush. What contiguous means is it will only erase colors directly in contact with the center of my brush. If you look at what I have here, I have this small area on this side of the red line that my brush is covering. I have this huge area on this side of my brush that my brush is covering. But the two areas do not have any direct connection because of the red area cuts it off. If I were to click once with contiguous set as my limit, only the side that is directly connected to the center of my brush is erased. Undo that, set my limits to discontiguous, do the same thing, and you'll notice it erases on both sides of this line. That's because when it's discontiguous, you don't have to worry about whether or not something's in the way. Really, really nice if you have objects with big holes in them. so you can get at all those extra areas that are hard to reach with your brush. The last option is find edges. Now, find edges, like contiguous, requires that any colors that are erased be directly connected to the center of the brush, or your sample point. However, unlike contiguous, find edges is a lot more strict with where the edge of the colors are. With a lower sharpness, even, we're going to get a slightly harder edge. Now zoom in here, you can see how we've still got some white mixed in there. You're going to get a harder edge because it's finding an edge sooner. If you have really soft edges and you're going to be using a low sharpness setting, you want it to be either contiguous or discontiguous. You do not want to use find edges. But if you have a very strict edge, find edges is a great setting to use. Okay, now, like I said, size and sharpness are the only two settings that you're ever going to touch. At least I hope I said that before. If I didn't, listen to me now. Size and sharpness are the only two settings you're ever really going to touch unless you absolutely need to change something else. At almost any other time, you're not going to touch any other options. But there is one option I need you to be aware of, and that's ignore lightness. Now, I have not actually managed to test this one out properly, but the theory is that if you have a background that is very gray or uncolored, like a metal door in front of a something, I don't know, and very colorful foreground, the difference between the lightness may be very minimal, which will confuse the brush. Remember, there's a difference between the color and how the color is. A gray color can be very light and match the lightness of, say, a sweater that's red, and it would actually confuse PaintShop Pro. In order to avoid this, you ignore lightness, but only in situations where either the foreground or the background has very little color. It's a grayish color, and correspondingly, either the foreground or the background, depending, is brightly colored by comparison. So only in those situations do you ever want to use ignore lightness. Otherwise, never, ever, ever touch that. And that will actually cover everything that we need to go over with the background eraser tool. We do have the use all layers option, which, as you know, will use all the layers to determine what colors to use, yada, yada, yada. But that's simple. So I'm going to leave you there. Part 2 over and done with.